kids, yes, back in the truck. Sorry I didn't get a video up last weekend. I ended up...
I'm really disappointed in her.
Ignore the voice you hear in the background. It was a three-day weekend. You see this? You see what I put up with? There you go. I can. They can see. Stop. Anyway, last weekend, it was a three-day weekend. I had Monday off, first paid holiday at the new job. But we ended up spending half the day on Saturday doing way too much yard work, cutting oak branches. What would you say the longest branch was that we cut?
Whose idea would you say that was?
It needed to be done. But what do you think was the longest branch?
Our weekend and
what do you
yours,
think was
the, but...
Were we 10, 12 feet?
Yeah, it could have been that long.
Anyway, we spent half a Saturday doing that. We did go out to dinner Saturday night, first time in a long time. It was very nice. Went to Outback. Hate the wait, love the food. Sunday I spent working on client projects, but I did actually rest and relax on Monday. A little client work, but otherwise I had a nice day off. So this weekend...
One day.
Yes.
One whole day.
sorry for jostling around. I'm trying to get the camera to behave itself.
Yeah, apparently it moves on its own.
The car is moving. Anyway. Anyways. So today is back to a normal weekend. We're running a bunch of errands. In fact, we've already made several stops, and I still haven't been able to shoot this video. Not much really going on. Anything exciting happened in our lives? But you know,
I can't remember the last time anything exciting happened in our lives.
Yeah, we live very exciting lives. Work's busy, but it's our busy season at my new job, so they've warned me. I end up having to put in a lot of extra time, not leaving on time, things like that, but that's life. You know, that's how it goes. I still am working on my wildlife video. I need to do the compilation. I saw a raccoon. First time I've seen a raccoon at the office, but I didn't have the camera out. And by the time I got the camera out, he was gone, and I couldn't shoot him. So, oh well. Maybe next time. I've been told we have about a 6-foot-long black racer that lives around a particular group of palmettos. Yeah.
6 foot?
Yeah. They showed me where he lives, but I haven't been able to see him. If I see him, I'll get him on video, assuming I have my camera out. And mostly, though, what I see are birds, lots and lots of different birds. Haven't seen my osprey lately. I miss him. Okay, we're making a stop, so I'll come back in a second. See ya. All right, we're back. We're out of this store. We're on to the next one. But here's a funny story for you. I'm going to tell.
I don't know how funny it is.
This gives you an idea of how
stupid.
goofy we are. So I was up way too late last night, first of all. And I always go... see Nifferblatt's paw.
Nags.
Tell him goodnight. Get my goodnight kiss.
She won't leave me alone until I kiss her.
Yeah.
Which, you know, have you ever had to kiss somebody that repulses you? Just, you know.
I don't think so. Anyway, so he was packaging up a shipment for a client that one of our stops today was to take that to FedEx. And so he had the packing tape out, and I tore off a little piece when he was away for a second, and I stuck it on him. So that became a goof, you know, we were playing with the tape. And he was threatening me.
We were mentally retarded, by the way.
He was threatening me, so I had to take the tape away, and I told him I was going to throw it away.
What did you say?
He told me that I wasn't allowed to put it on him, and I said I won't. And he said I wasn't allowed to put it on his clothes, and I said
right.
I wouldn't. I promised I wouldn't put it on his clothing or I'm trying to get you in frame. There you go. There you are. Wouldn't put it on his clothes or him. And I went to bed. And honey, did I maintain that promise? Did I not put it on you or your clothing?
That's right, but Fontzilla fans.
I threw it in the trash.
You can admit.
I threw it in the trash.
And yet, somehow, it ended up far from the trash. We're not sure how that happened. Very disobedient tape.
Yes, somehow.
Somehow it ended up. Where did it end up, honey?
Oh, I don't know, honey. I didn't see where it ended up. Where did it end up? Uh-huh. Somehow
that piece of tape crawled out of the trash and got on my toothbrush. So I said, get revenge, buddy. Unlike Nancy, I didn't, you know, like, oh, go in the trash and make sure you stay there. No, I said, go get revenge. And it did. It went on her toothbrush.
Right. So in other words, last night when he went to go to bed and brush his teeth, it had somehow magically appeared onto his toothbrush.
Somehow.
And this morning when I got up and it was time to brush my teeth, it was on my toothbrush.
Magically.
So I scolded that piece of tape. And I told it, no more of this, and I put it back in the trash can. But somehow, it got out of the trash can and made it all the way across the bedroom and ended up on Paul's foot powder stuff he uses.
Isn't that amazing, folks?
And look, there's a plane coming in.
Yeah.
And then somehow it got from the foot powder. I'm thinking Paul put it on my alarm clock.
No. I told it to do something entirely different. Just like you did, honey.
So it ended up on my alarm clock. What Paul doesn't realize is that I removed it. I put it back in the trash can.
Yeah.
But who knows where it
went. The legend of...
This is the most amazing piece of packing tape.
And now, if you can imagine, this thing's got crud all over it. It's got lint and dirt and all kinds of God knows what.
So these are the things that we do to each other.
These are the things Nancy starts.
I don't start everything.
You did start this one.
You started it by not wanting to give me my goodnight kiss.
Oh. We're going to go back that far?
Yes.
Can go back further.
All right.
How late were you?
I was a wee bit late.
You were too late.
I was.
Okay.
It was almost midnight.
And I would have been justified in not kissing you at all for being late to bed.
See, he punishes me. It's not. He's not a nice man.
You haven't seen punishment,
baby. He is not a nice... I want YouTube to know he's not a nice man.
Yeah. I put up with your crap. I've got to be a nice man.
All right, there's a peek at what life is like in the Foster household.
Constantly.
All right, gang, we're getting close to our next stop, and I've bored you enough, so talk to you next week.
I know you bored me, so.
See ya. Say bye.
Bye. See ya.